When making videos, we're often more focused on what we are filming than on the technical aspects of the video. But these technical aspects influence how the video will look, how easily it can be used, and how costly it will be to store and manage later on. So it's worth knowing some of the basics. Four key characteristics of video are format, frame size or resolution, frame rate, and scan method. Some cameras allow you to choose between multiple options for each. First, let's talk about format. Normally, when we say format, we are actually referring to two separate aspects of the video. The first is how the video data is represented digitally or encoded. This is called the codec. The second aspect is how the video data is packaged, which is called the container or wrapper. The way a video is encoded and the way it is packaged is important because codecs and wrappers are designed to support different levels of video quality and uses. Some work better or worse with specific computer tools. H.264 is an example of a common codec. It is used on all kinds of cameras and provides good visual quality for a relatively small file size. It is also a widely used codec for streaming video on the internet. However, H.264 is not as easy to use with older editing software. AVI, MP4, and MOV are examples of common containers for video. Not all container formats may be supported by the systems you are using. For example, AVI was developed by Microsoft, and MOV was developed by Apple, so they require additional software to work on each other's systems. So, before you film, be aware of how your video will be used down the line and how your format will affect your work. Also, keep in mind that using current and widely adopted formats will make it easier to preserve your videos in the long term. Another key characteristic of video to be aware of is frame size. Frame size is simply the width and height of the video image measured in pixels. People sometimes call this the video's resolution. Common frame sizes are 1280 by 720 pixels, sometimes simply called 720, and 1920 by 1080 pixels, sometimes simply called 1080. Some cameras allow you to choose between different frame sizes. A larger frame size can help make visual details clearer, such as faces or identifying marks. It also makes your video more versatile. You can show it on large screens, and you can always resize or crop the video image down for other uses. A smaller frame size creates smaller file sizes, but is more limiting because you cannot increase the level of detail in an image. Enlarging an image beyond its recorded frame size will just make it appear blockier or pixelated. Next, frame rate, another important characteristic of video. Frame rate is the number of video frames that the camera records every second. Some common frame rates are 25 and 50 frames per second, or 30 and 60 frames per second, depending on your country. A higher frame rate means that you capture more video in a given period of time. It can be advantageous when filming fast action because you capture more of the motion. This can allow you, for example, to see more details in the motion when you play a video back at a slower speed. A higher frame rate might be useful when documenting events for evidence, but keep in mind that it contributes to a larger file size. Finally, related to frame rate, is an aspect of video called its scan method. Some cameras have options for interlaced or progressive scanning. You often see this referred to as just I or P. Interlaced scanning is an older technology. It means that each video frame is made up of two fields that each only draw every other line of pixels in the image. The alternation between fields happens so quickly that you see a complete image. On the other hand, progressive means that each frame draws every line of pixels in order. It produces a better, clearer image. Computer monitors and newer televisions all use progressive scan. Unless you have a particular reason for using interlaced settings, it is a good idea to choose progressive scan when filming. There is not one correct set of options. Sometimes you might want the highest possible image quality, while other times your storage capacity may be limited. Your choices should ultimately depend on what is best for the way your video will be used or distributed. And if you are working with others in editing your footage together, you may want to ensure that all of your settings match. Think about what works for your situation and check your camera settings before you film. For more information on managing your digital video, check out our Activist Guide to Archiving Video at archiveguide.witness.org.